अस्सलाम अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे वी विल लर्न ग्रामर लेसन नंबर 2, सब्जेक्ट एंड प्रेडिकेट। सो व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय सब्जेक्ट एंड प्रेडिकेट चिल्ड्रेन? अ सेंटेंस इज मेड अप ऑफ टू पार्ट्स, द सब्जेक्ट एंड द प्रेडिकेट। व्हेनेवर वी आर स्पीकिंग अबाउट एनी पर्सन, प्लेस, थिंग और एनी आइडिया, that will be our subject. For example, the boys were playing football. So here, about whom we are talking? Who are playing football? The boys. So the boys is our subject. Were playing football is what? It is a part of a sentence, and we can say that it is a predicate, because a predicate is a tells about the subject. The predicate tells about the subject, what the subject is doing. Here the subject is boys. What are the boys doing? Playing. So it is a part of the subject, and we will call were playing football as predicate. So predicate always contains the verb. Your verb is what? Playing. I hope you all know what are verbs. Verbs are action words. Playing, dancing, singing, eating, running. So whenever from the sentence you want to find out the subject, you will ask the question who. You will ask the question who. Like, the boys were playing football. Who were playing football? The boys. So the boys is the subject, and rest of the sentence is your predicate. The house on the hill was guarded by a dog. Who the dog guarded? The house on the hill. So the house on the hill is your subject, and rest of the sentence is your predicate. One sock had a hole in it. Who had hole? One sock. So one sock is your subject. Had a hole in it is your predicate. Health is wealth. Who is wealth? Health is wealth. Okay. Now, whenever you want to find out the predicate, you will ask what. What. So, again we will see. The boys were playing football. The boys were doing what? Were playing football. So, were playing football is your predicate. So children, the next sentence is one sock had a hole in it. So what did the sock had? A hole in it. So had a hole in it is your predicate. Health is wealth. What is health? Is wealth is your predicate. So here we saw that the subject is coming first and predicate is coming afterwards. But it won't be every time, children. So whenever you have to find subject and predicate, you have to ask the question who and what. Who for subject and what for predicate. So here is the sentence. Here comes the brave man. Who comes? The brave man. Here comes. So here comes is your predicate. Up went the balloon. Who went up? The balloon. Went up is your predicate. So now children, let's do some exercises. The exercise number 1 is underline the subject in the following sentences. Good listeners look at the speaker. So here the verb is look. So look, with the help of look, we'll ask the question. Who look at the speaker? Good listeners. So good listeners is your subject, and look at the speaker is your predicate. I do all the work. So where is the verb over here? I do all the work. So do is your verb. Do is showing some action. So with the help of do, we will ask the question. Who do all the work? So I. So I is your subject. And do all the work is your predicate. So have you observed that with the help of the verb you have to ask the question. The word which is showing some action, you have to take that word and you have to ask who and what. Who do all the work? So I do all the work. What do I do? I do all the hard work. So do all the hard work is your predicate. Understood, children? Now the third one we will do. The violets began to bloom among their little leaves. So here the began word is showing some action, that is verb. So with the help of began we will ask the question who. Who began to bloom among their little leaves? The violets began to bloom. So the violets is your subject and began to bloom is your predicate. Good Morala inherited the cottage and the land around it. So inherited shows the verb. It is showing some action. So inherited. So with the help of the inherited, we will ask the question. Inherited. Who inherited the cottage? Good Morukla. So the good Morukla is your subject. Inherited the cottage and the land around it is your predicate. A cycle key with a blue keychain has been found on the ground. So here the verb is found. Action is showing that something has been found. So who found on the ground a cycle key with a blue keychain? So it is your subject. A cycle key with a blue keychain is your subject and has been found on the ground is your predicate. So now let's do question number 2. Underline the predicate in the following sentences. So to find the predicate, first we'll find out the subject and rest of the sentence will be your predicate. So the first one is Phidippides ran to Sparta like the wind. So who ran to Sparta like the wind? Phidippides. So Phidippides is your subject. Ran to Sparta like the wind is your predicate. Their large army had landed in the bay. So the verb is, which word is showing action? Landed. Who landed in the bay? Their large army. So their large army is your subject. Had landed in the bay is your predicate. All the people present in the court began to laugh. So began shows the verb. So who began to laugh? All the people present in the court. So began to laugh is your predicate. Carpets of rangoli are spread over large areas. Spread is your verb. So who spread over large areas? Carpets of rangoli. So carpets of rangoli is your subject. So you will not underline that. You will underline are spread over large areas. So the fifth one is, this clever and devoted teacher changed Helen's life. So changed Helen's life is your predicate. So children, we have solved 5 sentences of subject and 5 sentences of predicate. Rest of the remaining sentences you will do for homework. I want the homework to be done in your grammar notebook. Till you get your grammar textbook, you will do all your homework in your grammar notebook. And question number 3, you will do for homework. I will send you the pictures. I want all your homework in your grammar notebook. And start studying, children, as exams are going to start very soon. So whatever the other teachers have done, start learning the question answers and be ready for your exams. Till then, Allah Hafiz.